This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Radon is a chemical element with symbol. Unlike all the other intermediate elements in the aforementioned decay chains, radon is gaseous and easily inhaled. Thus, naturally occurring radon is responsible for the majority of the public exposure to ionizing radiation. It is often the single largest contributor to an individual's background radiation dose, and is the most variable from location to location despite its short lifetime. Some radon gas from natural sources can accumulate to far higher than normal concentrations in buildings, especially in low areas such as basements and crawl spaces due to its density. It can also occur in water where the water comes from a ground source, e.g. in some spring waters and hot springs. Epidemiological studies have shown a clear link between breathing high concentrations of radon and incidence of lung cancer. Thus, radon is considered a significant contaminant that affects indoor air quality worldwide. According to the United States Environmental Protection Agency, radon is the second most frequent cause of lung cancer, after cigarette smoking, causing 21,000 lung cancer deaths per year in the United States. About 2,900 of these deaths occur among people who have never smoked. While radon is the second most frequent cause of lung cancer, it is the number one cause among non-smokers, according to EPA estimates. Contents 1 characteristics 11 physical properties 12 chemical properties 13 isotopes 14 daughters 2 history and etymology 3 occurrence 31 concentration units 32 natural 33 accumulation in buildings 34 industrial production 35 concentration scale 4 applications 41 medical 42 scientific 5 health risks 51 in mines 52 domestic level exposure 53 action and reference level 54 relationship to smoking 55 relationship to passive smoking 56 in drinking water 57 testing and mitigation 6 see also 7 references 8 external links characteristics emission spectrum of radon, photographed by Ernest Rutherford in 1908 numbers at the side of the spectrum are wavelengths the middle spectrum is of radon, while the outer two are of helium added to calibrate the wavelengths physical properties radon is a colorless, odorless, and tasteless gas and therefore not detectable by human senses alone at standard temperature and pressure. Radon forms a monatomic gas with a density of 973. Condensation. Radon glows because of the intense radiation it produces. Radon is sparingly soluble in water, but more soluble than lighter noble gases. Radon is appreciably more soluble in organic liquids than in water. Chemical properties. Being a noble gas, radon is chemically not very reactive. However, the 38-day half-life of radon 222 makes it useful in physical sciences as a natural tracer because it is a gas at standard conditions. Unlike its parents, it can readily be extracted from them. For research, radon is a member of the zero valence elements that are called noble gases. It is inert to most common chemical reactions, such as combustion, because the outer valence shell contains 8 electrons. This produces a stable, minimum energy configuration in which the outer electrons are tightly bound 1037. Because of its cost and radioactivity, experimental chemical research is seldom performed with radon, and as a result there are very few reported compounds of radon, all either fluorides or oxides. Radon can be oxidized by powerful oxidizing agents such as fluorine, thus forming radon difluoride. It decomposes back to elements at a temperature of above 250. 11 minus S2O2 grams radon oxides are among the few other reported compounds of radon. Only the trioxide has been confirmed. Radon carbonyl RnCO has been predicted to be stable and to have a linear molecular geometry. The molecules Rn2 and RnXe were found to be significantly stabilized by spin orbit coupling. Radon caged inside a fullerene has been proposed as a drug for tumors despite the existence of ZV. No RnVII compounds have been claimed to exist. Radon octafluoride should be highly unstable chemically. Xenon octafluoride is thermodynamically unstable. It is predicted that the most stable RnVII compound would be barium pyridate Ba2 radon hexoxide, analogous to barium perxenate. The instability of RnVII is due to the relativistic stabilization of the 6s shell, also known as the inert pair effect. Isotopes. Main article, isotopes of radon. The radium or uranium series radon has no stable isotopes. 36 36 radioactive isotopes have been characterized, with atomic masses ranging from 193 to 228. The most stable isotope is 222Rn, which is a decay product of 226 Ra, a decay product of 238 U. A trace amount of the highly unstable isotope 218Rn is also among the daughters of 222Rn. Three other radon isotopes have a half-life of over an hour, 211Rn, 210Rn and 224Rn. The 220Rn isotope is a natural decay product of the most stable thorium isotope 232Th, and is commonly referred to as thorin. It has a half-life of 556 seconds and also emits alpha radiation similarly. 219Rn is derived from the most stable isotope of actinium 227Ac, named actinin, and is an alpha emitter with a half-life of 396 seconds. No radon isotopes occur significantly in the Neptunium-237 Napers decay series, though a trace amount of the extremely unstable isotope 217Rn is produced. Daughter's main article, decay chain section. 210 petabits, which has a much longer half-life of 223 years, beta decaying to 210 bi, 5013 days, beta decaying to 210 po, 138,376 days, alpha decaying to 206 petabits. Stable. The radon equilibrium factor is the ratio between the activity of all short-period radon progenies which are responsible for most of radon's biological effects, and the activity that would be at equilibrium with the radon parent if a closed volume is constantly supplied with radon. The concentration of short-lived isotopes will increase until an equilibrium is reached where the rate of decay of each decay product will equal that of the radon itself. The equilibrium factor is 1 when both activities are equal, meaning that the decay products have stayed close to the radon parent long enough for the equilibrium to be reached. Within a couple of hours under these conditions, each additional pCi/L of radon will increase exposure, by 0.01. To overall radiation levels as well because of their electrostatic charge. Radon progenies adhere to surfaces or dust particles, whereas gaseous radon does not. Attachment removes them from the air, usually causing the equilibrium factor in the atmosphere to be less than 1. The equilibrium factor is also lowered by air circulation or air filtration devices, and is increased by airborne dust particles, including cigarette smoke in high concentrations. Airborne radon isotopes contribute significantly to human health risk. The equilibrium factor found in epidemiological studies is 0.4. History and etymology. Apparatus used by Ramsey and Whitelaw Gray to isolate radon M is a capillary tube where approximately 0.1. Variations. When trying to measure radiation from thorium oxide, Rutherford noticed that the compounds of thorium continuously emit a radioactive gas that retains the radioactive powers for several minutes, and called this gas emanation from Latin emaner, to elapse, and emanatio, expiration, and later thorium emanation THM. In 1901, he demonstrated that the emanations are radioactive, but credited the Curies for the discovery of the element in 1903. Similar emanations were observed from actinium by André-Louis de Bierne and were called actinium emanation ACM. Several names were suggested for these three gases, X-radio, X-thorio, and exactinio in 1904, radon, thorin, and actin in 1918, radion, thorion, and actinion in 1919, and eventually radon, thorin, and actinin in 1920. The likeness of the spectra of these three gases with those of argon, krypton, and xenon, and their observed chemical inertia led Sir William Ramsay to suggest in 1904 that the emanation might contain a new element of the noble gas family. In 1910, Ramsay and Robert Whitelaw Gray isolated radon, determined its density, and determined that it was the heaviest known gas. They wrote that l'expression de l'émanation du radium est fort incommode, the expression radium emanation is very awkward, and suggested the new name Niton NT from the Latin nitens meaning shining to emphasize the radioluminescence property, and in 1912 it was accepted by the International Commission for Atomic Weights. In 1923, the International Committee for Chemical Elements and International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry IUPAC chose among the names radon RN, thorin TN, and actinin, and later, when isotopes were numbered instead of named, the element took the name of the most stable isotope, radon, while TN was renamed 220Rn and N was renamed 219Rn, which caused some confusion in the literature regarding the element's discovery, as while Dorn had discovered radon, the isotope isotope. He had not been the first to discover radon, the element, as late as the 1960s. The element was also referred to simply as emanation. The first synthesized compound of radon, radon fluoride, was obtained in 1962. The danger of high exposure to radon in mines, where exposures reaching 1 million. Research was initiated to address sources of indoor radon, determinants of concentration, health effects, and approaches to mitigation in the United States. The problem of indoor radon received widespread publicity and intensified investigation after a widely publicized incident in 1984 during routine monitoring at a Pennsylvania nuclear power plant. A worker was found to be contaminated with radioactivity. A high contamination of radon in his home was subsequently identified as responsible for the contamination. Occurrence. See also, radium and radon in the environment. Concentration units 210 petabits is formed from the decay of 222 Rn. Here is a typical deposition rate of 210 petabits as observed in Japan as a function of time. Due to variations in radon concentration, all discussions of radon concentrations in the environment refer to 222 Rn, while the average rate of production of 220 Rn from the thorium decay series is about the same as 222 Rn. The amount of 220 Rn in the environment is much less than that of 222 Rn because of the short half-life of 220 Rn 55 seconds, versus 38 days respectively. Radon concentration in the atmosphere is usually measured in becquerel per cubic meter. Becquerel per cubic meter, the SI-derived unit. Another unit of measurement common in the U.S. is picocuries per liter, PCI, L1. Indoors, though this varies widely, and 15. Natural radon concentration next to a uranium mine. Radon is produced by the radioactive decay of radium-226, which is found in uranium ores, phosphate rock, shales, igneous and metamorphic rocks such as granite, gneiss, and schist, and to a lesser degree, in common rocks such as limestone. Every square mile of surface soil, to a depth of 6. Radon mostly appears with the decay chain of the radium and uranium series 222 Rn, and marginally with the thorium series 220 Rn. The element emanates naturally from the ground, and some building materials, all over the world, wherever traces of uranium or thorium can be found, and particularly in regions with soils containing granite or shale, which have a higher concentration of uranium. Not all granitic regions are prone to high emissions of radon. Being a rare gas, it usually migrates freely through faults and fragmented soils, and may accumulate in caves or water owing to its very short half-life, 4 days for 222 Rn. Radon concentration decreases very quickly when the distance from the production area increases. Radon concentration varies greatly with season and atmospheric conditions. For instance, it has been shown to accumulate in the air if there is a meteorological inversion and little wind. High concentrations of radon can be found in some spring waters and hot springs. The towns of Boulder, Montana, Masasa, Bad Kreuznach, Germany, and the country of Japan have radium-rich springs that emit radon. To be classified as a radon mineral water, radon concentration must be above 2. By radioactive decay of 226 Ra present in rocks. Likewise, the saturated zone of a soil frequently has a higher radon content than the unsaturated zone because of diffusional losses to the atmosphere. In 1971, Apollo 15 passed 110. High concentrations of radon in homes were discovered by chance in 1985 after the stringent radiation testing conducted at a nuclear power plant entrance revealed that Stanley Watras, an engineer entering the plant, was contaminated by radioactive substances. Typical domestic exposures are of approximately 100. And 3, meaning given the 6-8-9-5-9-9-7 rule that the radon concentration is expected to be more than 100 times the mean concentration for 2-3% of the cases. The highest average radon concentrations in the United States are found in Iowa and in the Appalachian Mountain areas in southeastern Pennsylvania. Some of the highest readings ever have been recorded in the Irish town of Mallow, County Cork, prompting local fears regarding lung cancer. Iowa has the highest average radon concentrations in the United States due to significant glaciation that ground the granitic rocks from the Canadian Shield and deposited it as soils, making up the rich Iowa farmland. Many cities within the state, such as Iowa City, have passed requirements for radon-resistant construction in new homes. In a few locations, uranium tailings have been used for landfills and were subsequently built on, resulting in possible increased exposure to radon. Since radon is a colorless, odorless gas, the only way to know how much is present in the air or water is to perform tests in the United States, radon test kits are available to the public at retail stores, such as hardware stores. For home use and testing is available through licensed professionals, who are often home inspectors. Efforts to reduce indoor radon levels are called radon mitigation. In the U.S., the Environmental Protection Agency recommends all houses be tested for radon industrial production. Radon is obtained as a byproduct of uraniferous ores processing after transferring into 1% solutions of hydrochloric or hydrobromic acids. The gas mixture extracted from the solutions contains H2, O2, He, Rn, CO2, H2O and hydrocarbons. The mixture is purified by passing it over copper at 720. About 1. Typical indoor domestic exposure. Most countries have adopted a radon concentration of 200 to 400. Approximately 2,700 about 100,000 radicals, which results in genetic and other cell damage, resulting in increased rates of illness, including cancer exposure to radon. A process known as radiation hormesis has been suggested to mitigate autoimmune diseases such as arthritis as a result. In the late 20th century and early 21st century, health mines established in Basin, Montana attracted people seeking relief from health problems such as arthritis through limited exposure to radioactive mine water and radon. The practice is discouraged because of the well-documented ill effects of high doses of radiation on the body. Radioactive water baths have been applied since 1906 in Yakima, Czech Republic, but even before radon discovery they were used in Bad Gastein, Austria. Radium-rich springs are also used in traditional Japanese onsen in Masasa, Totora Prefecture. Drinking therapy is applied in Bad Brambach, Germany. Inhalation therapy is carried out in Gasteiner Heilstallen, Austria, in Swieradau Zdroj, Chernowa Zdroj, Kowary, Latic Zdroj, Poland, in Harghita Bay, Romania, and in Boulder, United States. In the U.S. and Europe there are several radon spas, where people sit for minutes or hours in a high radon atmosphere in the belief that low doses of radiation will invigorate or energize them. Radon has been produced commercially for use in radiation therapy, but for the most part has been replaced by radionuclides made in accelerators and nuclear reactors. Radon has been used in implantable seeds, made of gold or glass, primarily used to treat cancers. The gold seeds were produced by filling a long tube with radon pumped from a radium source, the tube being then divided into short sections by crimping and cutting. The gold layer keeps the radon within, and filters out the alpha and beta radiations, while allowing the gamma rays to escape, which kill the diseased tissue. The activities might range from 0.05 to 5 millicuries per seed, 2 to 200. Been put to use by some atmospheric scientists because of radon's rapid loss to air and comparatively rapid decay. Radon is used in hydrologic research that studies the interaction between groundwater and streams. Any significant concentration of radon in a stream is a good indicator that there are local inputs of groundwater. Radon soil concentration has been used in an experimental way to map buried close subsurface geological faults because concentrations are generally higher over the fault. Similarly, it has found some limited use in prospecting for geothermal gradients. Some researchers have investigated changes in groundwater radon concentrations for earthquake prediction. Radon has a half-life of approximately 38 days, which means that it can be found only shortly after it has been produced in the radioactive decay chain. For this reason, it has been hypothesized that increases in radon concentration is due to the generation of new cracks underground, which would allow increased groundwater circulation, flushing out radon. The generation of new cracks might not unreasonably be assumed to precede major earthquakes in the 1970s and 1980s. Scientific measurements of radon emissions near faults found that earthquakes often occurred with no radon signal, and radon was often detected with no earthquake to follow. It was then dismissed by many as an unreliable indicator. As of 2009, it was under investigation as a possible precursor by NASA. Radon is a known pollutant emitted from geothermal power stations because it is present in the material pumped from deep underground. It disperses rapidly, and no radiological hazard has been demonstrated in various investigations. In addition, typical systems re-inject the material deep underground rather than releasing it at the surface, so its environmental impact is minimal. In the 1940s and 50s, radon was used for industrial radiography. Other X-ray sources, which became available after World War II, quickly replaced radon for this application, as they were lower in cost and had less hazard of alpha radiation Radiation Health Risks Main Article, Health Effects of Radon in Mines. Relative Risk of Lung Cancer Mortality by Cumulative Exposure to Radon Decay Products in WLM. From the combined data from 11 cohorts of underground hard rock miners, though high exposures widely implemented, radon exposure was linked to lung cancer among non-smoking miners of uranium and other hard rock materials in what is now the Czech Republic, and later among miners from the southwestern United States and South Australia. Despite these hazards being known in the early 1950s, this occupational hazard remained poorly managed in many mines until the 1970s. During this period, several entrepreneurs opened former uranium mines in the USA to the general public and advertised alleged health benefits from breathing radon gas. Underground health benefits claimed including pain, sinus, asthma and arthritis relief, but these were proven to be false since that time. Ventilation and other measures have been used to reduce radon levels in most affected mines that continue to operate in recent years. The average annual exposure of uranium miners has fallen to levels similar to the concentrations inhaled in some homes. This has reduced the risk of occupationally induced cancer from radon, although health issues may persist for those who are currently employed in affected mines and for those who have been employed in them in the past. As the relative risk for miners has decreased, so has the ability to detect excess risks among that population. In addition to lung cancer, researchers have theorized a possible increased risk of leukemia due to radon exposure. Empirical support from studies of the general population is inconsistent, and a study of uranium miners found a correlation between radon exposure and chronic lymphocytic leukemia. Miners as well as milling and ore transportation workers who worked in the uranium industry in the United States between the 1940s and 1971 may be eligible for compensation under the Radiation Exposure Compensation Act. RECA surviving relatives may also apply in cases where the formerly employed person is deceased. Domestic level exposure. Radon exposure, mostly radon daughters, has been linked to lung cancer in numerous case control studies performed in the United States, Europe and China. There are approximately 21,000 deaths per year in the U.S. due to radon-induced lung cancers. One of the most comprehensive radon studies performed in the United States by Dr. R. William Field and colleagues found a 50% increased lung cancer risk even at the protracted exposures at the EPA's action level of 4 PCI/L. North American and European pooled analyses further support these findings. A controversial epidemiological study showing decreased cancer risk versus radon domestic exposure 5. Analyses can be rejected. Most models of residential radon exposure are based on studies of miners, and direct estimates of the risks posed to homeowners would be more desirable because of the difficulties of measuring the risk of radon relative to smoking. Models of their effect have often made use of them. Radon has been considered the second leading cause of lung cancer and leading environmental cause of cancer mortality by the United States Environmental Protection Agency. Others have reached similar conclusions for the United Kingdom and France. Radon exposure in homes and offices may arise from certain subsurface rock formations, and also from certain building materials, e.g., some granites. The greatest risk of radon exposure arises in buildings that are airtight, insufficiently ventilated, and have foundation leaks that allow air from the soil into basements and dwelling rooms. Action and reference level. WHO presented in 2009 a recommended reference level, the national reference level, 100 becquerels per cubic meter, for radon in dwellings. The recommendation also says that where this is not possible, 300 becquerels per cubic meter should be selected as the highest level. A national reference level should not be a limit, but should represent the maximum acceptable annual average radon concentration in a dwelling. The actionable concentration of radon in a home varies depending on the organization doing the recommendation. For example, the United States Environmental Protection Agency encourages that action be taken at concentrations as low as 74. Effect of radon and passive smoking. See below. Radon, like other known or suspected external risk factors for lung cancer, is a threat for smokers and former smokers. This was demonstrated by the European pooling study. A commentary to the pooling study stated, "It is not appropriate to talk simply of a risk from radon in homes. The risk is from smoking, compounded by a synergistic effect of radon for smokers without smoking. The effect seems to be so small as to be insignificant." According to the European pooling study, there is a difference in risk from radon between histological types. Small cell lung carcinoma, which practically only affects smokers, have high risk from radon for other histological types such as adenocarcinoma, the type that primarily affects never smokers. The risk from radon appears to be lower. A study of radiation from post-mastectomy radiotherapy shows that the simple models previously used to assess the combined and separate risks from radiation and smoking need to be developed. This is also supported by new discussion about the calculation method, LNT, which routinely has been used. Relationship to passive smoking. An important question is if also passive smoking can cause a similar synergy effect with residential radon. This has been insufficiently studied. The basic data for the European pooling study makes it impossible to exclude that such synergy effect is an explanation for the very limited increase in the risk from radon that was stated for non-smokers. A study from 2001, which included 436 cases never smokers who had lung cancer, and a control group 1649 never smokers, showed that exposure to radon increased the risk of lung cancer in never smokers, but the group that had been exposed to passive smoking at home appeared to bear the entire risk increase, while those who were not exposed to passive smoking did not show any increased risk with increasing radon level in drinking water. The effects of radon if ingested are similarly unknown, although studies have found that its biological half-life ranges from 30 to 70 minutes, with 90% removal at 100 minutes. In 1999, National Research Council investigated the issue of radon in drinking water. The risks associated with ingestion was considered almost negligible. Water from underground sources may contain significant amounts of radon depending on the surrounding rock and soil conditions, whereas surface sources generally do not, as well as being ingested through drinking water. Radon is also released from water when temperature is increased, pressure is decreased, and when water is aerated. Optimum conditions for radon release and exposure occur during showering water with a radon concentration of 104. Testing and mitigation. Main article, radon mitigation. A digital radon detector. A radon test kit. There are relatively simple tests for radon gas in some countries. These tests are methodically done in areas of known systematic hazards. Radon detection devices are commercially available. Digital radon detectors provide ongoing measurements, giving both daily, weekly, short-term and long-term average readouts via a digital display. Short-term radon test devices used for initial screening purposes are inexpensive, in some cases free. There are very important protocols for taking short-term radon tests, and it is imperative that they be strictly followed. The kit includes a collector that the user hangs in the lowest habitable floor of the house for 2 to 7 days. The user then sends the collector to a laboratory for analysis. Long-term kits, taking collections for up to 1 year or more, are also available. An open land test kit can test radon emissions from the land before construction begins. Radon concentrations can vary daily, and accurate radon exposure estimates require long-term average radon measurements in the spaces where an individual spends a significant amount of time. Radon levels fluctuate naturally, due to factors like transient weather conditions, so an initial test might not be an accurate assessment of a home's average radon level. Radon levels are at a maximum during the coolest part of the day when pressure differentials are greatest. Therefore, a high result over 4. Installing a radon sump system in the basement. Installing a positive pressurization or positive supply ventilation system. According to the EPA, the method to reduce radon primarily used as a vent pipe system and fan, which pulls radon from beneath the house and vents it to the outside, which is also called sub-slab depressurization, active soil depressurization, or soil suction. Generally, indoor radon can be mitigated by sub-slab depressurization and exhausting such radon-laden air to the outdoors, away from windows and other building openings. EPA generally recommends methods which prevent the entry of radon. Soil suction, for example, prevents radon from entering your home by drawing the radon from below the home and venting it through a pipe, or pipes, to the air above the home where it is quickly diluted. And EPA does not recommend the use of sealing alone to reduce radon because, by itself, sealing has not been shown to lower radon levels significantly or consistently. Positive pressure ventilation systems can be combined with a heat exchanger to recover energy in the process of exchanging air with the outside, and simply exhausting basement air to the outside is not necessarily a viable solution, as this can actually draw radon gas into a dwelling. Homes built on a crawl space may benefit from a radon collector installed under a radon barrier, a sheet of plastic that covers the crawl space. For crawl spaces, the EPA states, an effective method to reduce radon levels in crawl space homes involves covering the earth floor with a high-density plastic sheet of vent pipe and fan are used to draw the radon from under the sheet and vent it to the outdoors. This form of soil suction is called submembrane suction, and when properly applied is the most effective way to reduce radon levels in crawlspace homes. See also Chemistry Portal International Radon Project Lucas Cell Radiation Exposure Compensation Act Radiohollow Books View or Order Collections of Articles Radon Period 6 Elements Noble Gases Chemical Elements Sorted. References Carrot Haynes, William M., ed. 2011 Costa Rican Colon's Handbook of Chemistry and Physics 92nd ed. Boca Raton, F.L., CRC Press p. Carrot Thomas, Jens 2002 Noble Gases Marshall Cavendish p.